Hello friends, welcome to here my new course on data structure. What is data structure? In computer science, a data structure is a data organization, management and storage format that enables efficient access and modification. Each data structure contains information about the data value, relationships between the data and functions that can be applied to the data. Let me give you an example here. Whenever you go to your library, you will find that if you want to search a biology book, you will go and find it directly that this is in that rack and at this position. So question comes, how? Because when librarian is putting that book in that rack, he is following a particular data structure. And data structure that librarian is following is putting the books by alphabetical order. So he will say that A will come first, by B will come second, then C, then D, then E. Similarly, when you are searching for some word in dictionary, what you are doing, you are just going alphabetical order. Now, in both the cases, there is one difference here. In dictionary, you have to write once and you have to read n number of times. But when you come to library, you have to update the books regularly because some students have taken the books and some have returned that back. So again, you have to maintain that order. That means the books in the shelf are changing frequently. Even the people are coming to taking the book from the shelf. So reading and writing, that is keeping the book and moving the book out of the shelf, is normal equivalent function. For one book, it can be one time you are keeping that in the shelf, and number of times the people come to check that book and keep that in the shelf, and once it can be moved out of the shelf. So everything that you are keeping in a shelf or in a dictionary, there is some mathematical computation behind that. And in this case, it is alphabetical order. Now, coming back to our data structure, I have a hard disk on my system. Initially, it was in MBs, but now that hard disk is very cheap and you can have GBs and terabytes of size of the hard disk. Now, you are going and putting some data on hard disk. That is, you are just going and throwing that data in the hard disk. Now, if you are just going and throwing some data in the hard disk, then when you will go, come again and come to read that data, you have to find that data in the hard disk. So, in which condition it is useful? That such condition. If my read are very large, or my read is once and write are large, let me think about it. If I have to write once and read frequently number of times, this structure is not useful because I am just throwing the data. Now, let me revert the condition. I have to write lots of data into the hard disk, but once in a while I will read it. If this is the condition, then my first condition is very true, that you just bring lots of data and I will throw that into the hard disk without knowing where I am putting it. I am just noting down the locations and it is not in a sequence also. So I am just bringing the data and throwing it into the hard disk. Now, since my write operation is very large and read will happen once in a year or once in a while. And also my read operation can take some time, so that is acceptable. So this, if this is the condition, you can go and write it anywhere. But if your read will happen n number of times and your write will happen once, then what will happen? That is, I will go and write a data and n number of people will come and read that data. That is, that reading of data is very crucial. In such condition, basically, I take help of indexing. Now, whenever that data requirement will come, I will read that location from my cache or RAM and will form that data from the hard disk and return that data. So it is all about how you will structure that data, how you will manage that data. Characteristics of data structure. Linear or non-linear. This characteristic describes whether the data items are arranged in chronological sequence, such as with an array, or in an unordered sequence, such as with a graph. Homogeneous or non-homogeneous. This character describes whether all data items in a given repository are of the same type or of various types. Static or dynamic. This character describes how the data structure are compiled. Static data structure have fixed sizes, structures and memory locations at compile time. Dynamic data structures have sizes, structures and memory location that can shrink or expand depending on the use. If I am talking about data structures, let me talk about some mathematical operations that I can perform above that data. And in this case, let's I have taken off whether a number is prime or not. Any number which is divisible by 1 or itself only is prime number. Is 7 a prime number? Let's see. Let's 7 divided by 1, no remainder. 7 by 2, yes remainder. Hence not divisible. 7 divided by 3, yes remainder. 7 divided by 4, yes remainder. 7 divided by 5, yes remainder. 7 divided by 6, yes remainder. 7 divided by 7, no remainder. Means 7 is divided by only 1 and itself. Hence it's a prime number. But there is one check here. Why I need to check the 7 till 7 only, or whether n with till n? If any number is checked till half of its length, it is sufficient. Let me take an example of 7 only. If I would have checked 7 with 1, 2 and 3, 7 is divisible by 1, fine. But 7 is not divisible by 2 and 3. So there is no need to check it till 4, 5, 6, 7. You can check similarly for 11. You can check similarly for 13. You have to just divide it from 1 to n divided by 2 and it would be sufficient. Let's see, is prime 11? You can check in the similar fashion. Algorithm to check is prime. This is the algorithm. I have integer I. I have m initialized to 0 and flag initialized to again 0. And I have said m is equal to number divided by 2. This is the number which I am checking. For num equal to 0, num equal to 1, return false. If your number is 0 or 1, it is not prime. Else, divide that number from 2 to m. What is m? That is number divided by 2. If number modulus I double equal to 0, this is a modulus operation which will give you the remainder. If remainder double equals to 0, make flag is equal to 1 and return false. End of for loop. If flag still if flag is 0, then only this number is prime. Else return false. Simple. What are the different types of data structures? And the first data structure that comes into my mind is arrays. An array stores a collection of items at adjoining memory locations. Items that are the same type get stored together so that the position of each element can be calculated or retrieved easily. Arrays can be fixed or flexible in length. Let me give you the characteristics of arrays. If you will see, this 0, 1, 2, and 3, and 4 are the memory locations of array. And all these memory locations are in sequence. If you will have this much amount of memory available, then it will be allocated to array, else not. So, work on arrays, you need to have sufficient amount of memory available in a sequence. Second thing, arrays are initialized at static at compile time. When you will initialize the array, you will give some memory to it. After that, you cannot go and change that memory. At the time of initialization only, you will define the type of the array, that what type of element you will keep in that array. That type cannot be changed after that. On the similar line, we have linked list. What are the linked list? If you will see and compare it with array, in array we have a sequence of memory locations. But in list, we have different memory locations. That is, this memory location can be anywhere on the disk. This can be anywhere and this can be anywhere. But this memory location is divided into two boxes. One of the boxes is to keep the data. And the other part is to keep the address of the next memory location. This is important. This box is divided into two parts. One is to keep the data and another is to keep the address of the next box. Now, when you will work on linked list, a linked list stores a collection of items in a linear order. Each element or node in a linked list contains a data item as well as a reference or link to the next item in the list. This is a singly linked linked list because each node is attached to a single connection. And here is the head which will tell the start of the node. So if I know only the value of this head, I can go and read the data in a linked list. When you have started data structure, so the first question that should come into your mind is that, Arun, in what condition we should use arrays and in what condition we should use linked list? And the answer to it is, if you have this memory location present in a continuous form, you can use array. If you have segregated different memories at different parts, that is the segmented memories available, you don't have large amount of memory at one place, you can go for linked list. Simple. But this simple is not so simple. Let me explain why. When you have segmentation of your memory, the operating system is taken care of. And I will say in this era, you will not have any space problem. Now, what to decide? Whether I use for array or linked list. Now let's see the problem. Array, I have write any element at this location. And I know that the next element would definitely will be available at this location. So if I will read any value, I can read it in sequence. Okay. Now let comes to linked list. I have come and write any element here. Now I have come and write any element here. Now I know this memory. I can go and assign this, take the memory reference of this node and can keep it here. It will take some time in adding or putting the elements in linked list. But it is very easy in keeping an array. You just have to keep the sequence array 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can go and keep that. But in linked list, you have to maintain that address. So there is some constraints or problem or friction in keeping there. Or some time is going and taking in keeping this address. Okay. Let's take second condition. Now I have keep that element. That is, I have write the elements. And write are very frequent. So I have taken arrays. Now, let's come and update some data. Update means I just want to come and update the data at second index. So I will just read first, second. I will just come to direct in O1 complexity. What is this O1 complexity? I will just tell you. I will just come to this second index. I know, go to that second index and you will find that element. You just go and update that. But if you want to update any value at this location, I need to update value of C to Z. So first I will go to head, I will read A, I will read B, I will read C. Oh, this is C, update it to Z. So here I have to go through all the nodes. I cannot go directly, but in arrays I can go directly. So in this condition also, array is more preferable. And linked list are putting some friction again. Let's me come up with one more condition. I have to add one element between 2 and 3. What is that element? Let's say I want to add 5 here. What I would do in array? I don't have any space here. So what I will do, if my array has space, I will shift this 4 here, this 3 here, and then I will go and keep 5 here. But in linked list, I will just bring a node and just connect with the my existing node structure, because I have to give the reference of this new node here, and this new node will have a reference of me. So it is like a chain. You can just bring a node, a single component of a chain anytime, and connect between the linked list. So if the addition of new value between the existing element is the problem, or update or delete is the case, addition, update or delete, then linked list is a better option than array. Let's see what all other data types are available. Queue. You all have go to movie theater. You have seen the people standing in a line for a ticket. That line is called queue. And what is the algorithm that is applied there? That is first come and first have a ticket. Whoever has joined that queue first will have a ticket first only. So that is the principle of queue, that is first in, first out. Here I have taken a queue where I have 0, 1, 2 and 3. This is the oldest element and this is the youngest element. Here I am inserting my elements in the queue, and from here I am deleting the elements in the queue. So whatever element has added at this location is the oldest element, and whatever I am newly adding here is the youngest element. So this is first in, first out. Stack. You all have a stack of books on your table, or inside a box basically, you are keeping your books. If I have a box and I have keep a book 0 here, then above that I have a book 1 here, then I have the book 2 here. I am adding it from the above, and even if I want to remove the book, I can remove from the above one. That is, if I have added 2 after 1, so I have to remove 2 before 1 only. That is last in but first out. I again repeat, this is last in but first out. This is LIFO. A stack stores a collection of items in a linear order that operations are applied. Whenever you will think about stack, think of a box or a bucket in which you are putting element one above the other. The last element that you have put, you will remove that first. But in queue, just imagine a queue of people standing in for tickets. Whoever joined the first, he will get the ticket. Whoever joined last, he will get the ticket last. The next data structure is tree. What tree says, you have one root and you have different nodes. The node which doesn't have any child node is called leaf. A tree stores a collection of items in an abstract hierarchical way. Each node is linked to other nodes and can have multiple subvalues known as children. Here, each node can have different number of childs. Since this has 3 childs, this has 1 child, this has 2 childs. If I will talk only about this tree, this sub part of the tree, this is binary tree. Why it is binary tree? Because it has 2 childs, one left and one right. In what condition we need to use tree, we will discuss that in our further lectures. Let's talk about graph. What is graph? Any node, a second node, and they are connected by an edge. In each node of a graph, we call it as vertices. There can be directed graph, that is from A to B, or non-directed graph. There is no direction between A and B. A graph stores a collection of items in non-linear fashion. Graphs are made up of finite set of nodes, also known as vertices, and lines that connect them, also known as edges. These are useful for representing real-life systems such as computer networks. It's an example of it. Hash table. A hash table or a hash map stores a collection of items in an associative array that plots key to values. Let me explain. A hash table or a hash map stores value in terms of key and value pair. That is, hash table or hash map has 2 parts. One is key, and another is well. So first I will know what is the key. When I will call out that give me the first name, so it will search within the hash map that this is the value. I will search for last name and it will give me same. I will search for age and it will give me 33. What is the importance of data structure? Data structures are essential for managing large amount of data, such as information kept in database or indexing services efficiently. Proper maintenance of data system requires the identification of memory allocations, data relationship, and data process, all of which data structures help with. Additionally, it is not only important to use data structure, but it is important to choose the proper data structure for each task. Choosing an ill-suited data structure could result in slow runtimes or unresponsive code. Let's see all in details. Here I will also show you the prime number example that I have given you in data structure. This is the algorithm that I have given for prime number, and I have written a Java program for that. Let me go with the algorithm. I have this prime method here where I am passing the number. It is returning a boolean variable or boolean value. I have initialized it with integer I am 0 flag 0. I have divide m is equal to number divided by 2. If number is equal to 0, number is equal to 1, simply return false. It is not prime. Else, take I is equal to 2 till I less than or equal to m. That is, I have to start from 2 and till half of that number, and I have to iterate 1 by 1, that is I plus plus. Now, if number modulus I equal to 0, that number is divided by I and remainder is 0, then make flag is equal to 1 and return false. This for loop will go through from here to here, end of for loop. After that, if no one is going and accessing this if loop, that means initially we have put it flag is equal to 0. So here also flag will equal to 0. That is, this number is not divided by any of the number till 2 to half. In that case, your flag will be 0 and you can return true. That is prime. Let's go and check it for initially the example that I have taken for 7 with my explanation. And the answer should be is prime 2. Let me go and check it for 11. Answer is true. Let me go till 12. And answer should be false. And that's all. Thanks for watching this. In next video, I will talk about the complexity of data structures.